Hi, in this presentation, we are going to speak about the genetic algorithm part 1. So, what is a genetic algorithm? A GA is a search algorithm based on the natural selection and genetic algorithms. We have here a block diagram illustrating the genetic algorithm main loop. From this, we can see that the GA operates not only in one solution, but in a set of potential solutions. This set of potential solutions, we call it the population. So this is a big difference as opposite to the single or trajectory solution methods, as the hill climbing and simulating annealing. So, we start with a set of potential solutions. We call it here the whole population. And then we evaluate all the elements of the population, all the chromosomes, in the context of a problem. Then we have the three main operations in the operators in the GA. It is the selection, the crossover, and the mutation. We are going to speak a little bit about each one of these. So the selection, we select the best ones to mate and to be crossover and mutated, and then these generate a new population. The new population then is going to replace the old population. This replacement can be total or partial. So, the first thing that we need to address in the standard or original binary genetic algorithm is how to represent a solution, how to represent the chromosome. And if you think about a game consisting, adapted from Goldberg book, consisting of five switches, and according to the switching combination, we can have a different payoff, okay? A function and a payoff for each different combination of these settings, okay? So, this is a typical example where it is quite natural to represent the on state by 1 and the off state by 0. So, this solution, this potential solution that we see here in the figure is represented or encoded by this string, binary string, 10110. This is also one of the particular distinguished features of GAs, is that the original GAs uses codes, operates in codes. And we are going to see an example how does it work. So, the first thing that you can do is randomly initialize the population. So, this can be done using the flipping of a coin procedure. So, with 50% chances, we generate zeros and ones to fill, in this case, each one of the five positions of each chromosome. So, we have in this case 1, 2, 3, 4 elements for our chromosomes in the population. So, the only thing that the GA needs to guide the search is to know what is the payoff value for each solution, for each candidate. So, we have to see which is the merit for each one of these elements in the context of a problem. That's the only thing the genetic algorithm needs to evolve the search. So, after we have the random population, this is a totally blind population concerning the problem, no information inserted. So, we need an objective function that is problem dependent. In this case, we are going to use a toy problem, a function, a quadratic function, and this is the fitness value for each one of these elements. So, the first element is 169, the second merit is 576, the third one 64, and the fourth one 361. So, if you plot here a table with the index of each one of the elements and the strings, we can see that the best one in terms of a maximization is going to be the second one. So if we evaluate the sum of the fitness and divide each one of these fitness by the sum, we determine the relative merit in percentage of each one of the elements. And we can see that we got quite a strong element in this random generated population. It's the second one is quite strong, and the second best is the fourth one. And then we got the third one is the one, and the last one is the third one. So, the question now is, how can we do the selection? How can we artificially simulate the survival of the fittest principle? So, one of the most popular methods is known as the roulette wheel. So, we can see that the roulette wheel basically assigns portions of the roulette as a pie chart, and we can see that each one of these of the elements is going to be have a share proportional to the merit. So, for instance, is the element number 2 has a relative merit of 49.2, is going to have almost half of the roulette wheel. Okay, so each one of these portions will have a number of slots according to the relative importance. Okay, so in this case we are going to turn around the roulette wheel, and of course the number 2 is going to have more chances to be selected than number 3, okay, which is the weakest in this 4 population members. Okay, this is quite interesting from the algorithm point of view, how to implement the roulette wheel in algorithm. This is one of the things that we're going to see in the practical lesson. So, after we select the best elements, we have to cross over the information, the genetic material, to generate the new population. And in this binary coding, one of the most popular methods is called the single point crossover. This means that you are going to select randomly a point, a crossover point, is going to be selected randomly, in this case is this one, according to a probability law. And in this case, we are just going to switch this bit with this one. So the 1 is going to be put it here, and 0 goes up. So we can see that from the 2 progenitors, we are going to generate 2 descendants. Okay? And in this case, the probability crossover, the crossover probability represented by PC, is quite high. It should have a high value because the crossover is an operator that it happens with high rates, higher rates in nature. Okay, so after crossing over and generating a new population, these population elements are going to be subjected to a mutation operator. So the question is how to simulate the genetic mutation. It's quite easy. It's just do the flip of a coin, bit flippings, according to a certain probability. And this probability is called the mutation probability, and usually it's quite small, because the mutation in the real systems, in the natural systems, biological systems, it occurs with a low rate, a small rate. So in this case it could be exactly 0.001. Okay? The regulating these parameters, the crossover probability and the mutation probability, are the 2 heuristics that need to be adjusted in the genetic algorithm. So, in this case, because we got a very small amount of bits, and it's like 5 bits per string plus the 4 is 20 bits, so the mutation is with a small rate is not going to happen, and so there is no mutation. We are going to see the new population is just a result, in this case, of selection and crossover. So now we got the new population, we have to evaluate the new population, and it is interesting to see, okay, did the new population improve relative to the whole population, and so to replace the whole population, and this is okay. If you see the maximum value in the whole population was 576, the average value was 293, and guess what? The maximum value in the new population is higher, 729, and the average value also is higher, 439. So it improved both in the maximum value and also in the average value. And this is a feature of the GA that it tends to improve the average value from generation to generation. Okay, and with this slide, with just the class notes reference, I conclude this talk, the presentation. Thank you very much.